TSR Subramanian, former cabinet secretary Hartosh Singhbal, political editor of Open, Vinod Mehta joins the panel. Chandan Mitra represents the BJP tonight, and Randeep Singh Surjewala represents the Congress party. It's getting bigger. Chandan Mitra, we've just revealed the full details of Parakh's letter to the cabinet secretary. I don't know if you heard what Meetu Jain was reporting right before we went on live. But one thing which it proves is that Parakh, even in 2005, was telling the cabinet secretary that the coal mafia has infiltrated the coal ministry, and I am being made to take decisions against rationality and against public interest, and there is no political commitment to take on the coal mafia and fight law and order. Now, these are fairly serious charges. Given this backdrop, should the CBI really look at the political leadership's role in Coalgate rather than hound just one bureaucrat?
Well, Arnab, let me tell you that the Pioneer too has accessed the letter, and so before I left office, I have seen the letter myself. And it is indeed, as you say, an explosive letter. He has said directly that the coal mafia exists within the ministry. Now, if such a thing is the truth, which is what we have been saying all along, that certain people are doing the bidding of the coal mafia, then ultimately the minister in charge, when these blocks were allotted, was the Prime Minister. So the Prime Minister has done the country no favour by saying he is above the law. Now, he is not above the law, we all know it. And therefore, it is only proper that he should be investigated. He should have been named in that FIR. And yes, of course, he will have to submit himself to answering questions. I am also intrigued that the Prime Minister says today that he has nothing to hide and he is willing to answer questions. Now, when he spoke on this issue in Parliament, 1 minute, Arnab, let me finish. When he was asked on this, he made a statement and refused to take questions. The Prime Minister is answerable to Parliament, he is answerable to an investigation, because a humongous loot of national resources happened in this Coalgate scam. And therefore, the Prime Minister has to submit himself to inquiry. It would have been only in the fitness of things if he had also said that since I am directly subject of investigation, I offer to step down till the investigation is complete and submit to all questions that may be asked of me. And if I am exonerated, I come back to my position. I would have been happier if he had said that.
Well, he hasn't said that. He hasn't said that. We've only heard the Prime Minister say, I have nothing to hide. Now, TSR Subramaniam, this letter which is written to the Cabinet Secretary makes one clean point, one clear point, that the political leadership was aware of the rot. It was aware that the Coal Secretary of India had put on record that, you see here, in this particular case, the coal mafia had infiltrated the system and it had political patronage. That, in my view, TSR Subramaniam, is the fundamental point that comes out in the Parakh letter. What do you think is the key news point that comes out of the Parakh letter?
Arnab, I fully agree with you. This is something that insiders always knew, but it is very rare that in such explicit, clear terms it has been articulated by an officer. I think the only parallel I can think of is 1993, when Vora, who is now in JNK, wrote the mafia politician nexus report, which has still not been released. This letter also would not have come into public view but for the Coalgate scam, and we have to thank CAG and Times Now for that. Having said that, three things stand out now. The Prime Minister, I won't call him Prime Minister anymore, he was Coal Minister. He is being addressed as Coal Minister. In fact, PMO has zero locus standi. They have no business to interfere in the status report, in sort of vetting recommendations. His secretariat as coal minister was the coal ministry. I think the Prime Minister has to be asked three very broad range of questions. One is that in the background of this letter, how did those 200 arbitrary allocations take place, number one. Number two, in the background of this letter, what inquiry did he conduct to ensure that the written direction, it is not an anonymous letter from the public.
No, certainly not.
It is a letter
not.
From the secretary to the government,
yeah.
The secretary to the department. It is from him. What action was taken and how it was done. And thirdly, the secretary had asked for auction.
No, the
Why
question here
he
is...
like Dhritarashtra not allow
no, no, the
for
question,
5 years?
No, this Dhritarashtra argument now will become
question.
Very serious.
Are
because,
they,
because you see, no, what happens here, Mr. Subramaniam and Mr. Randeep Singh Surjewala has to answer some questions today. Because I compared this to the 2G scam. In the 2G scam, Mr. Surjewala, the Prime Minister of India, received a series of letters series of letters, not one, warning him of wrongdoings in the telecom ministry. Right? However, besides the three letters to Raja in the months of November, December 2007, he did not pursue the matter rigorously. The people of India will now ask the Prime Minister of India, what action did you take when you got this warning from Parakh in 2005? What action did you take? Parakh told you about the rot. What action did you take on the rot?
Arnab, I had lost connection earlier. There are two issues which are very clear from the letter that was just read out on your channel. I have not had a look at the full text of it. Number one, Mr. Parakh wrote to Cabinet Secretary, not to Prime Minister. I just want to correct one.
What, the Prime
Number
Minister
two,
wouldn't be aware?
Mr. Parakh?
The Prime Minister wouldn't be aware of this letter?
Arnab, please. I would humbly request you, please have the patience to hear my complete answer. Secondly, Mr. Parakh talks about a systematic failure where the trade unions of, as also the various coal companies, the stakeholders, that is the state governments, and officials in the coal ministry are supposedly making him helpless in changing the system.
No.
So that systematic failure was what?
No,
just
everything is not
just
a systemic
give me one
failure.
More line.
No, everything is not a systemic
give me,
failure.
Give me just one more.
No, no.
Arnab, kindly have the patience to hear one more line since
just,
it's an
okay,
important issue you are raising today.
That I believe that you have understood that paragraph wrong. Anyway, please continue.
Also, we have to see when he speaks about systematic failure, what was the malady? The malady was allocation of coal block on first-come, first-served basis since 1993 by four different governments, including by the Bharatiya Janata Party, 41 coal blocks allocated. Yes, it was wrong. Prime Minister took note of it in 2005 itself along with Mr. Parakh and said perhaps time has come to introduce a bidding process provision in the MDMR Act.
Sir,
the MDMR Act
sir,
still
please,
then provided
no, no, please,
that the coal block would be
no,
allocated by no. state with concurrence of the central
sir,
government.
Sir, please understand.
And
please
it
understand.
Is the same Prime Minister.
This is a very serious charge. I please make it this point. This letter is the second instance in which Parakh wants the government. Hartosh, let me get you in, isn't it? In 2004, he had written about the pulls and pressures faced by the screening committee. In 2005, just like in 2004, his concerns were ignored. The letter I have is of 2005. And to place on record, on the 29th of January 2006, Shibu Soren was once again handed over the coal ministry. Shibu Soren was handed over the coal ministry in 2006 again, despite the coal secretary telling him he is perhaps the singularly most controversial and wrong person to be handling this ministry. He is not a person who has the will to take on the coal mafia. I am asking you, Mr. Surjewala, why did the Prime Minister of India reward such a person by giving him back the coal ministry? Why did he do that?
Arnab, we are discussing contents of a letter that I have not had the opportunity to see. But what I heard, Ritu, please, since I have not, the letter is not before me, I have not even had a look at it, please have the patience to hear my reply today. Give me that indulgence, since I don't have the letter in front of me. I have heard very patiently what Ritu Jain just read out. She has, according to read, a portion of the letter of Mr. Parakh, where he talks about a systematic failure from state governments involved,
no.
from the various coal companies in the states, from trade unions, from the coal ministry officials. This is a matter of procedure.
We are getting two
the
rebuts.
Procedure was first come, first served. That procedure was changed by none less than the Prime Minister of India, who was opposing to change of procedure. The people
of,
who were opposing change of that
has not seen the letter.
From
he should
first
not talk
come, first served to a bidding process was the Bharatiya Janata Party.
He should not talk on something which he has not
it
seen.
It was Vasundhara Raje Sindhya ji in Rajasthan.
Anywhere in this
it
letter.
Was Jharkhand
in
government
this,
of Arjun Munda. It was
no,
the Odisha
no
government in
no
Odisha
reference.
Who was
no,
then an alliance partner.
Now there is a big problem.
I'm sorry, Mr. Surjewala, you know nothing of this subject. You know nothing of this subject.
Opposing a change of procedure.
I request you, getting two rebuts. Chandan Mitra, complete your first rebut. I want to place on record here what this letter tells is that Parakh told the Cabinet Secretary of India on the 22nd of March 2005 that the coal mafia lay within the coal ministry. This is a very big thing for a coal secretary to say, that my own ministry has the coal mafia which has embedded it. I think it's a very important charge. And given that the coal secretary was flagging off such a serious concern to the government, what was the prompt action taken by the government? To the contrary, I find that the same person, Shibu Soren, is given back the ministry in 2006. I think Chandan Mitra wanted to rebut with your permission, Mr. Surjewala. Chandan Mitra first, and the Hartosh Singhbal, and Vinod Mehta hasn't even spoken yet. Yes, Chandan Mitra.
No, first I want to tell my friend Mr. Surjewala that since he has not read the letter, he should not, just on the basis of what he is hearing, just fling wild allegations since he hasn't read the letter. Then he should say, I'm sorry, I haven't read the letter. Let me read the letter and get back and answer your questions. Because this is an explosive letter which has completely torn the last big leaf that the Prime Minister and the Ministry, yes, and the Ministry was wearing. I mean, this says the mafia exists within the ministry. The coal secretary, a very senior, honest and respected officer, he's a retired man now, but everybody agrees that he's a very honest officer and is not given to loose talk. So when he says that,
You continue to level allegations of impropriety against this very coal secretary and on this very channel, sir. Your spokespersons have said Mr. Parakh should be investigated.
No, Prime Minister,
I just want to remind Arnab Goswami was there on the channel and he conducted the program.
No, one minute. No, don't start making wild guesses because you don't know anything on the subject.
This is with due regards to you, sir. This is classical BJP double speak.
No, I also have due regard, but today, I'm sorry. Yes, the fact is Mr. Parakh has also admitted that he was bullied.
He was bullied
into accepting what the ministers, yes, he was bullied.